वन मिनट फेसबुक लाइव पे मैं जा रहा हूँ, 1 मिनट हाँ, वेट वन
ओके
मिनट।
सर, ओके सर। I'm sorry, sir. We are unable to hear you. Could you please unmute yourself?
Sandeep, please share the Facebook Live link.
Yes, sir. He's doing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Give me a few minutes. Aditi, we are ready now. Aditi.
Okay, we are ready.
Yes.
Okay, so we can start.
Good afternoon, Mr. Kulkarni. Welcome to the show.
Good afternoon.
Thank you for coming to the show. And
my pleasure.
Dear students, I would like to introduce you to a person with over 15 years of experience in the hotel operations, human resources and learning and development. Mr. Kulkarni's career in the field spans across hospitality and education sectors. In his journey so far, he has been associated with multiple brands like the Leela, Accor Hotels and Hilton. Mr. Kulkarni is an alumnus of IHM Goa, who began his career in hospitality in the year 2005 with Leela Hotels, Resorts and Palaces in housekeeping department. Having worked with Leela, Mr. Kulkarni also has worked with Marriott family, with JW Marriott, Juhu, Mumbai, in the housekeeping department also. Mr. Kulkarni ventured out in the field of education and has worked with Rizvi College of Hotel Management as lecturer. He joined Accor Hotels in the field of learning and development and eventually moved into human resources. Mr. Kulkarni has completed his master's in tourism studies and PG diploma in HR from the Symbiosis Pune. He's an avid reader and a travel enthusiast and has keen interest in rail fanning. That's very interesting. We would like to know what is rail fanning, but later on in the show. So please let the session be started, and those who have the questions, please put it across to Ms. Aditi Chand, and she will, and we will all ask the questions at the end of the show. Mr. Kulkarni, the stage is yours.
So thanks a lot. First of all, IIHM Ahmedabad, Aditi and sir, for inviting me to interact with dear friends. So, as I see, the technology has improved so much. I can see people with various smiling faces sitting at their home, and we all are together because of these improved technologies. First of all, good afternoon to all of you, all the budding hospitality professionals here. I guess they are in your third years. They are starting their third year. So one of the final phase of your education has been started. And let me tell you, you will always remember this third year for your lifetime. It's because you are the only people who are starting their third year in such a difficult scenario. So when you are going to become executive chefs, GMs, housekeepers, or wherever you're going to reach in your final career destination, you're going to talk about this, that in our third year, there was something, there was a pandemic called as COVID-19, and it was a very difficult situation. So to start off with, basically, I hope everyone is safe, sound, healthy. Please stay safe, stay sound, follow the rules and regulations. I can see I'm very much new to Ahmedabad, and I can see people do not follow regulations here. So please follow the government regulations, whatever they have been saying. Also, you can guide me, how do we proceed with the session?
So we have, what we could do is that we could have from your experience, your experience in the hospitality industry,
okay.
How has the journey been? And now that the students are in the third year, we would like you to explain to the students what is the expectations from the industry of the students at the time of the interviews, campus selection.
Yeah. Yes.
Being in the HR, I think you're the best equipped person to deal with that sort of a question. So we can take it to, means we can start with your journey, and
yeah.
then we can deal with that question.
Okay. Thanks a lot, sir. First of all, thank you for the great introduction. It was a big revision journey for me of my career. So guys, I also started like you all in way back in 2005. I did my hotel management from IHM Goa. Spent 3 years there of studying. I'm basically from Mumbai. So for me, traveling to Goa was a bit easier because of the distance. And I did my 3 years of hotel management there. My first exposure to something called as hotel was at Renaissance Mumbai as an industrial trainee. And I would say fortunately or unfortunately, I saw a hotel which is one of the biggest hotel in India. So with more than 1,000 keys, one of the biggest convention centers, and almost 12 F&B outlets. The journey, the training was actually a big thing for all of us, because in those times, currently in these times also, when people say that if you do your industrial training with Renaissance Mumbai, you have been well equipped with everything. So of course, I have gone through with all those I would say extra days, because there were days where we were into the hotel only, and we were just working. But it was a good experience. Moving ahead, I chose housekeeping as my area of interest. I moved ahead, got through with Leela Goa as a management trainee. Joined Leela after passing out from IHM Goa. Been there, completed my management training. It was a mixture of everything. We cross-trained in every department, and I being into housekeeping, so that was my forte. So I was being there for a longer period of time. Leela Goa being one of the, again, a resort destination, one of the luxury, super luxury hotels in the country. We got trained in various aspects of the hotel management. We were being trained in front office, we were being cross-trained in revenue, in reservations, F&B, kitchen, stewarding, front office, all these operations departments, as well as the other departments of human resource, training, finance. So all these departments I got trained in, and then moved to my core department of housekeeping. There was a time to change. I completed my MT and moved to JW Marriott Juhu in Mumbai as assistant manager in housekeeping. It was a big shift from a luxury resort to a proper business class hotel. At that moment, JW Juhu was one of the, again, very, very luxurious hotel. First JW in India of the Marriott. Very dynamic, that hotel since opening till our time has always been giving a GOP which was much more than what it was being expected out of it. So had a span of around 1.5 years, got a chance to reconvert the old Viceroy Hotel into Marriott in Hyderabad. Being in 3 or 3.5 years with housekeeping, I had developed interest in training. I was a departmental trainer. Apart from the operations of your day-to-day in housekeeping, I was a key person who was in charge of training for the department team members, as well as I used to do soft skills. I used to do lots of training activities with my departmental team member into your technical knowledge. Aditi and sir, am I audible? Because I'm not using the earphones.
Yes, sir, you are.
Yeah,
yes. Thanks. Perfect.
If I'm not able to, just stop me because I keep on continuing talking. And then later on, I realize that, okay, nobody has heard anything.
Keep that in mind, Mr.
Jindal. Right. You can call me Harish or Aditi.
Okay.
So, moving ahead, I decided to change my career from hospitality to hospitality education. So one of the premier college, private college in Mumbai, that is Rizvi College of Hotel Management, was my next career destination. I have been with Rizvi for almost 2.5 years. I got a chance to move from my hardcore housekeeping operations training to front office operations and majorly soft skills. For this 2.5 years, I was a key person to develop students for interviews. We used to do classes with my third years, and we used to develop them. There were extra classes which were being organized to them, and developing them for the interviews. That was my key forte again. Eventually moved out from Rizvi to Accor. Accor had recently entered India, and it was a very small chain at that time, that period of time. It was just 8 hotels, and I joined one of the hotels with Mercure Lavasa and Lavasa International Convention Center. So it was a combo role for me for both two units. For many of you who don't know Lavasa, Lavasa is a small planned hill station near Pune in Maharashtra. Now it has been a ghost city, but during that time it was like a very booming city. It was a private first private city which was being getting developed, and because of close proximity to Pune as a city, Mumbai as a city, it was getting developed as a tourism center. It was getting developed as a alternative hill station to all the crowded hill stations which were there nearby Mumbai and Pune. It was getting developed as a weekend home for all the people who were staying nearby. And it was a kind of a picturesque city for every one of us. So having spent as a training manager there for 2.5 years, I got a chance to move into proper hardcore human resource. Managed both the hotels almost for 3 years, and then moved ahead, got transferred within Accor to Ibis Nashik. Ibis is a very separate, different brand of Accor. It's a very economy, budget kind of a hotel, but very trendy, very unique for youngsters like you all, and very limited service. We don't have Ibis didn't had any bellboys. Ibis didn't had any in-room dining. It was a very simple kind of a bed and breakfast hotel. They had banquets. So my role with Ibis was to totally move in hotel, develop this new brand, launch the brand into the city, launched this brand as a from the employer perspective, because many times it happens that youngsters do not want to work with brands called as Ibis, because many times it happens that, oh, this is a very small brand, this is a very economy brand, there are no outlets, there is no much of banqueting, there is no room sizes are small, very limited service. But let me tell you, these brands will evolve a lot in future, such brands, because Accor was the first hotel chain which developed this brand in India, and then every other chain had followed them with their economy or a mid-scale brand. So it was fun working with Ibis. Very limited staffing for a room of around 123 room hotel. We were just 68 people of us managing the entire hotel. So that was something very different for me, because I've been always working with super luxury, where the manning ratio is 1:2 or 1:2.5, and then suddenly moved down to a ratio of 0.5. So having spent 3 years with Ibis, Accor moved me again to Novotel Pune. Novotel Pune was again a different brand of Accor. Novotel, I would say it was a proper full-fledged hotel. It was a 223-room hotel where I took care of human resource, L&D operations. This was one of the challenging hotels for me because first time as a HR head, I dealt with unions. Pune being a city in Maharashtra, every one of you might be knowing or hearing that how Shiv Sena is strong in Maharashtra. So got a real hands-on experience of dealing with unions, how to handle the union committee members, team members. One of the important aspects in my human resource career has happened in Novotel Pune. I signed the first wage agreement for the hotel and even for Accor Hotels India with Bharatiya Kamgar Sena for the period of 3 years. So that's one of the greatest learning experiences for me. I was being transferred by Accor again to Novotel Goa Dona Silvia. This was the first franchise hotel of Accor in India. So every one of you might be knowing that what is a franchise and what is a managed hotel. So Accor had given a first franchise hotel, and they expected me to move to that hotel and specifically inculcate Accor values, Accor core systems, Accor processes into it. Being there for a year, I got a different opportunity to move out of Accor. It was a very difficult situation for me, because being in Accor for almost for 9 years, I was planning to move out. And then I got an opportunity to work with Marriott. I'm very new in Marriott. Of course, this is the second chance of my being in Marriott, but in human resource, I've been very new. I'm just 5 months old in system. But one of the biggest chain in the world, and currently I got an elevation to manage two hotels, two proper operating hotels, Renaissance Ahmedabad and Four Points by Ahmedabad. So that's my journey in a short while. Apart from that, as I read a lot, every day it has to be. I have to read some of the other things, some books. That's one of the major part for me. I'm a traveler. You could have seen from my career graph, I've been traveling all over the country, specifically Goa, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, Pune, Nashik. So been traveling a lot. Apart from that, also I keep on traveling specifically for leisure. I mentioned that I like rail fanning, and sir wanted to know what exactly this rail fanning is. So this is a very unique hobby which I've been developing from my childhood. So in my childhood, we used to travel a lot by train, and I had a very, very fascination towards the Indian railways. How does the Indian Railway operate? What kind of coaches they have? What kind of engines they have? What are the various signal systems? What are the meaning of those signages which are there nearby the track? So eventually, after getting more and more information, Mr. Pugal came to me for my assistance when I grew up. And then I got to know a term called as rail fanning. So basically, these are your Indian Railway fans which keep on gathering information about how are the things happening in railways. And then they gave a term to all of them called as rail fans. So many times we go out onto a specific stretch of a railway line and do lots of photography there, find out what are the various, how the engine sounds are different from a different to of a goods train, of a passenger train, or a different type of train. So that's what some of my hobbies are all about. I would not like to spend much time on me talking. I've already spoken for 15 to 20 minutes, and I can see 3-4 students saying when this guy is going to keep his mouth shut. So I think so, Aditi, we can have more on question answers or interactive sessions.
Definitely. So first and foremost thing I need to say, the life that you live is very dynamic. The things that you do while, like, you like reading, so that is something indoor that you do, but at the same time you like rail planning, so you go out, mm-hmm. you do a lot of things, so it's like, you know, two different personalities together. So that is very interesting. Yeah. And so Harish, I would like to know, since the students are going to appear for their interviews in a couple of months, and you know, they would step in the industry from next year, as a recruiter, as a human resource manager, what do you look into the candidates, the profile? Is it just the knowledge, or is it even the, you know, the charisma that they have, how dynamic they are? So what are the things that you look into a candidate while you're recruiting them?
Thanks for the question, Aditi. It is that's in mind of every student who is planning to appear for the industry, your interviews, or for any interviews, for that matter. Even when I see myself going for an interview, the first question in my mind is, what this guy is going to look at me? So that's a very apt question. Guys, let me tell you, first of all, as I started my conversation with you, you're going to go through a very tough time, because maximum, please, you should not quoting me in this, but maximum of the industries at this moment has freezed the external recruitments. So I didn't want to discourage you, but surely keeping our fingers crossed, and if the situations get normal very soon, surely till quarter three, end of quarter three or start of the quarter four, the recruitments might open up, and surely the new interviews or anything will start. So now the next question in your mind is that, so will there be no interviews for us? I would say no, it is not right. Yes, there will be interviews for you. There will be the selection committees will be visiting you all. The panels will be visiting you all. But when your MT starts, when your HOT starts, or when your associate level program starts, is something which is little bit uncertain because of the situation which we all are going through. So having said that, what should a person prepare for an interview? It's like, basically, knowledge is something which you cannot say that I have full with me after passing out from the college. I currently would not be able to say that my knowledge is full of the hotel industry and I know everything of the hotel industry. That's not the right way to say. Because this is an over-evolving process. Majorly, your students or all the students here would have understood or they would have learned something which is in their syllabus, but they would have not been knowing that what exactly, how to operate that into the hotel. So knowledge is not a criteria for a person who appears for an interview. So then, do we say that if I don't know anything, will I get selected? So again, the answer is no. I would say that you need to prepare yourself. How do I prepare myself? So in these days, we all have been practicing to cover ourselves with various covers which we keep on wearing. We are something different and we show something we are different. So my only simple thing to you all is uncover yourself. How do you uncover yourself? Is basically you just need to present yourself the way you are. Okay. The moment you accept the reality that this is how I am and this is how I am going to present myself to my panel, everything will fall into automatically at its place. I would not give information that you need to be very, very well spoken. You need to be very, very pleasant minded, or you need to be something kind of always smiling. These are your basic things which you all of you have practiced this for last 3 years. So this comes without saying. But the simple thing which we expect you all is that the way you are. We are ready to hire a person the way he is. Not the person who is unnecessary showing off and he is not actually that. And let me tell you this everything, specifically if you are looking for a Voyager training in Marriott or in any other hotel chains, if you are looking at that, then majorly what all these tests which are there, the rounds of interview which are there, you will be easily able to find it out that what actual real personality you are. So my simple saying is that be yourself, be what you are in front of the panel.
True enough. Thank you. I would also like to ask one more thing. Now, since apart from the major operation department, these human resources also, are booming as a career option for many graduates. So what would you like to say about human resources as a department and the opportunities that, the students might get in future if they plan to get into human resources as well?
Surely, yes. We do look forward for management trainees in human resource. Because human resource as a department in hotels has also evolved a very long time. Old days, it was a personal department which was a very very rigid kind of a department, which was very kind of a policing department. You are coming late, let's go to human resource and the human resource manager will shout at you now. Or, you committed a mistake, now let's go to human resource department human resource manager or human resource person will rectify you, give you a warning letter. So there was lots of injustice which has been done on the human resource department in our past years, that we were being made like to look like villains, and everyone should be scared of us, and everyone, the moment HR person walks in into the corridor, nobody should talk anything, everyone should be quiet, no gossiping in front of us. We were being kept aside from those wonderful gossips for so many years, which goes around into the hotel. And the moment you see HR person walking in, they used to say, no, HR, aaya, abhi band karo, abhi baat mat karo. So it has been evolving. Predominantly, when we say HR, the only one thing comes into our mind is recruitment and payroll. They say that HR का ये दो ही काम है, एक recruitment करना, एक payroll करना और police की तरह घूमना. So if you see majorly the payroll part of maximum of your international hotels or international chains are being outsourced now. Okay, all the international hotels are looking to human resource as a business partner. So what is this exactly a business partner? Basically, my role as a HR is to guide the management that by making some changes, by making some alterations to my existing organization, to my existing ways of doing business, how my profitability will increase, how my maximum revenue maximization would happen. Also, how as an employer, my brand value increases. My major role here is to create an employer brand perspective for young talents like the students whom I am talking about. Gone are the days where people used to talk that, okay, people will keep on coming in. There will be a line outside. You just give an advertisement that we're doing a walk-in interview and people would join us. So gone are the days. That's not. Okay. So many times I've been interacting with young students very frequently. I was a very frequent visitor to IHM Pune, your Pune campus. So students have mindset already been put up into their mind that I want to work with an employer who has these things in their mind. I want to ensure that I work only with those people, otherwise I'm not going to work. We call these young students these days as millennials. So dealing with millennials is very, very difficult. So my HR department also has to get evolved around to tackle these millennial students. So coming back to this question of yours, that yes, the career options in human resource are very, very open. The numbers are quite less compared to operational departments, but yes, there are. So we had a Voyager training with the Renaissance Ahmedabad for 1.5 years. After his 18 months training, he graduated as an assistant manager, and now currently he is managing Four Points Bengaluru as an individual HR head. So that's something which is, it's not like that your options are open only for operational departments. Yes, as a human resource, career-wise, there is lots and lots and lots of potential, which all these students can actually try it out. Only one thing is that in case if you really have, if you're a people's person, in case only if you are okay to work sitting on a desk for n number of hours and working with lots of Excel sheets and reports and all those things, if you are okay with that, then only go forward for human resource as a career option. If you are a person specifically in hotel industry operations, people are very, very, they cannot sit at one place. Okay. They are always moving around here and there. They're constantly doing around some or the new things which they want to do. But HR, you would not be able to do that much. Of course, there is employee engagements. There are other things which are there in human resource, but your main core focus should be on these things.
Okay. Thank you, Harish. Sir, I would leave it up to you if you have any questions to ask to him, and then we'll move ahead and we'll ask students to ask their questions. I'm sorry, sir, requesting you to please unmute yourself.
Yeah, sorry. So I would like to ask you one question. That is, post COVID-19, what are the changes that you are expecting in the hospitality industry?
Thanks, sir. One of the very most difficult question, and we all into hospitality fraternity is seeking an answer for this. But me as a person, if you ask me, yes, it's a very, very difficult phase and it is going to continue for a long. You might be knowing that the hotels are already with lots of less occupancies, or zero occupancies. Some of the hotels have already shut down. And moving ahead, it will be not a normal life for all of us. That's why in Marriott, we have termed this post-COVID phase as new normal. So that's the new normal what we are going to have. You will be finding that, yes, there are lots. Your restaurant covers are being reduced to 50% so that we have social distancing. Masks and sanitizers will be a very permanent feature, not only in hotels, but in our day-to-day life also. In terms of hospitality industry, is what I anticipate is that, yes, till quarter four, there will not be a normalcy in the business figures, what we are actually going through. But to some extent, I find that in 2021, we might back to get normal to get those figures what we had budgeted for. But yes, it will be a very, very difficult phase. Many of you would have been finding it on Facebook, finding it on LinkedIn, the news about layoffs, the news about retrenchment. The pay cuts are already being introduced by almost all the major international hotel firms. So the thing I would say it is nobody's mistake, but everyone's mistake.
Okay. So now, let's get back from COVID-19. Let's go to something else. How much of, let's say, when we are talking about students coming from the hospitality background, from hospitality schools, joining in hotels and other hospitality ventures, what would be the essence of success? What would be that thing that would lead them to success?
So I would say there would not be only one thing which would lead you to a success. There are various factors. What I would say is, first of all, the mindset of a student, that initial level, initial 3 or 4 years which you're going to put up into the industry is very, very important. First of all, I would like to urge everyone to join hotels, because even you will agree, sir, that maximum of the students passing out from the hospitality industry colleges do not wish to join hotels. Yes, there are various reasons. It is very, very, there is lots of hard work is there. We are the least paymasters as an industry. So many students would not go forward for a career, actual career in hospitality. But I would urge that, yes, initial struggle of 3-4 years is required, and which is required everywhere in all other industries. You go to ITs, you go to manufacturing, you go to FMCGs, everywhere it is there. Also, your initial years which are there are very, very important. Why would I say that? Is basically it is your duty to observe the things and learn the things. Guys, I would say that currently once you join the hotels, there will be two part. One will be younger you, and the other one will be the older others. Yes, there are some things which you guys are very, very tech savvy. You guys are very, very technologically oriented people. But the same thing would not be applicable to the people who are working into the hotels. The most important part, what they have, is their knowledge and experience. So it should be a very mutual give and take. Do not have a attitude with saying that, okay, I am a hotel management pass out, I am a management trainee, I am a voyager, I am an NGL, whatever it is. And would not say that I would not do this, I would not do that, I will be doing only presentations and all those things. That's in case if this amalgamation which is there between the staff and you, which happens very easily, then success is all yours. The only thing is that initial years, how do you manage with both the part is something very important.
Okay. Yeah, Aditi, let's see if the students have some questions.
Yes, sir. So any one of you have any questions, please unmute yourself and ask, sir, so that you can clear your doubts. This is the best platform where you can, you know, get in touch with the human resource manager one-on-one and clear your doubts before going and giving the interviews for your career ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Nate.
Yes, tell me.
Sir, please, if you can address us on Marriott Voyager program in detail and how Marriott conducts interviews for that.
Can you repeat? I didn't hear you clearly.
Sir, please, if you can address us on Marriott Voyager program and how Marriott conducts interview for that.
Okay. So you want to know about Voyager?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Voyager is basically a name which has been given by our country level HR head, who is a senior director for human resource for South Asia, Mr. Gurmeet Singh. He has named this program as a Voyager because you are the guys who want to start with your new voyage, and you're going to assist my company to achieve that journey. Or you guys are going to choose my company. I would not say that we are going to choose you. You are going to choose us. So Voyager is something, a very, very unique kind of a program. From the name itself, it starts that it gives you a very different feeling of not calling you something called as a management trainee. So very proudly people call themselves as Voyager. It's an 18-month program where there are three phases to it. Once you get selected, is first one is your associate level, second one is your cross-departmental, and third one is your supervisory level. Okay. You also get a chance to do your cross-training into a different Marriott hotel, either in the city or either in your same geographical location. That means you cannot go out of South Asia. So in South Asia, we have India as a bigger country, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, and Sri Lanka. As a group of these countries, we call our area as a South Asia. Bigger area is Asia Pacific. And then bigger area more than that is Asia Pacific, including China. So coming back to Voyager, how does the selection happen? So this will be the first time which I will also be going forward for the selection of Voyagers. If not immediately, but surely in quarter four or quarter end of quarter three. So our first is a very basic interviews. There are online tests we have, which is done at the college level. Either we visit a specific college or either we call the students from other colleges to a centralized location. The various other ways, the movement moving ahead, we would be having an assessment centers into various Marriott locations. So Ahmedabad might not be one of the assessment centers. The Ahmedabad students will be going to Mumbai for their assessment centers. It's an entire day's exercise where there are lots of case studies which have been given to the students. There are lots of live examples which have been posted to them on the spot. And then the evaluation happens. How do they go ahead into all these things? If you ask me, how do you prepare yourself? It's basically not something which is which you can prepare. It is how do you spontaneously behave, or how spontaneously do you act in those situations will help you out whether you are selected or not. Also, only one particular aspect will not help you in your selection. You need to perform equally in all the tasks which are there in your assessment center, as well as the interviews which happen at the college level. I would also say be very, very hands-on with your figures, your arithmetic calculations, which is very, very important. If you are not very good at figures or arithmetic calculations, start working on them, because this will help you out a lot, because there will be some of the exercises which will give you lots of input into your figures, whether it is any department, whether it is front office, housekeeping, kitchen, because the assessments for everyone is same. We don't have separate assessments for department specific. So eventually, after the assessment centers are being completed, then later on, we announce the results that India level, who all have got selected. Depending upon the preferences which the candidate has given, and depending upon the vacancy which the hotel has all over the Marriott India, the person has been placed. Again, after 18 months, the person gets placed as an assistant manager in the same department, either in the same hotel or a different Marriott hotel altogether. As far as remuneration is being concerned, I would not tell you right now, because the remuneration figures might change. But yes, it is one of the at par of the industry level. What voyager remuneration as a voyager you will be getting. I hope I am clear, Meet, right?
Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Any further questions on the same thing, Meet, or is it very clear now?
No, sir. It is very clear.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Any more questions, students? Because we just have 4 minutes left, and then
have to go ahead with your other session.
So if you have any doubts, please clear it now.
Good afternoon, sir.
Anwar, please be a bit louder.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Anwar.
Yes, sir. Can you differentiate us, sir, between the associate and the management trainee as a starting of a journey? What would be the advantages?
So, Anwar, if I'm getting your question correct, you are asking me that what is better, an associate, joining as an associate, or joining as a management trainee?
Yes, sir.
Anwar, there would not be, I would not say both the areas do not have any disadvantages. As an associate, yes, the major difference between joining as an associate and a management trainee is the outlook or intellectual capacity of everyone. Some of them might have that intellectual capacity to join as a management trainee, while some of them, your capacities are different. Okay, I would not say that they don't have, but for example, I as a person cannot understand mathematics. I have been suffering from my childhood, and that was the only subject which got my percentage down. So that does not mean that I am not good for to do something else. So same way, if you are not getting selected as a management trainee, that does not mean that you are not better for to do something else. One of the major advantages of you joining as an associate into any of the hotel firms is that you get to know each and everything of the hotel and your operations and the loopholes into it. I, as a manager, if I do not know the loopholes in my department, what my staff would be doing or what my team members would be doing, I am not a right manager. And this is one of the major advantage what you get as an associate compared to a management trainee. A management trainee might be, it's a very in-depth program, but sometimes it might become superficial because it is a span of around 1.5 years where that person has to grow and acquire the knowledge. While associate, you be there for 2 years, 2.5 years, and then you move up into your rank. So you get time there to understand your department very well. So I would not suggest that, okay, join only as an associate or join only as a management trainee. It is purely up to you. How do you adjust? Because I've seen, like, for example, yesterday, you all had a session with Sagar. So Sagar is my assistant manager in housekeeping who is currently heading the department. He never was a management trainee anyway. It's one of the live example because he joined as an associate and then moved up into his ranks. And now he is there where he is. So first of all, do not have any halo towards that management trainee. Oh, management trainee is something very big. I have seen many people that who are such a big failure even after getting selected as a management trainee. And is that does that addresses your question?
Yes sir.
Thank you sir.
Any more questions? Harish, I believe that is it. And if students have any more questions, then I'll get in touch with you.
Surely. Please, you can. You are always welcome. Even the students are. You can share my number with them, so that whenever you get fixed somewhere, whenever you find that okay, you need guidance, or you find that okay, I might be of your help somewhere. Please do not hesitate to give me a call, so that we can move ahead and try to find out some solution for you.
Thank you. Sir, just a minute, sir, I'm unmuting you. Yeah, done.
Thank you, Mr. Kulkarni, for your address and the valuable advice which you have gave the students. I hope it will be fruitful. We'll be in touch once things come to normal. I'll try to visit the hotel and get in touch with you.
Yes, for sure. Thanks a lot, sir, for giving me a chance to come and meet the students. It was nice interacting with them. Thank you, Aditi, for organizing this. And surely we will be in constant touch over a period. I think so. You are always in touch with Himanshu. So he is the best person to interact with from my point of view. Sometimes I might not be able to get in touch with you, but Himanshu is there, who is there in constant touch with you. And also thanks a lot for the students, friends. Thank you for listening very patiently to me. I know it might be sometimes I'll be very boring, but thanks a lot for listening, and wish you very, very all the best for your careers in future. Looking forward to meet you all. I might visit down to the college sometimes when your college also reopens. and we will interact with you. And lastly, please be in touch. If you need any help, please feel free to call. Okay?
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. So we exit now?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Stay safe, all the guys. Thank you.
And students, please start logging to Professor David Foskett's class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Harish. Have a great day.